everyone. So recently I came across a very interesting feature in Excel, which I call it as a picture scramble or a picture mosaic. Now in this, what happens, this is a spin button which I have over here, and when I click on the up button over here, and the slowly picture unfolds and we have the entire picture. This seems exactly similar to the picture scramble which we generally play. How to create this in Excel? This is very simple and will just take 5 minutes. So in my new sheet, the very first step is to get the background as that particular picture. So I'll go to my page layout tab, background, from a file, and let me just select the picture which I want to insert. So this is the picture which I want to insert. You can adjust the picture a bit so that you can get more columns, or the number of rows, required number of columns and rows which you want to. So maybe I want more columns, so it looks good. And I'll just decrease the size like this, or let me just reduce this a bit. Also, I need to adjust the row, so I will just decrease the size of one row and that will be enough. So this is my one picture which I have over here. Now the next step is basically to remove all of these other pictures which are not required. Now how to remove that? It's very simple. What we just need to do is need to select all the columns which we have towards the right, and then simply turn it into a white color, right? Similar thing can be done with the rows which we have below. And this is how we have managed to remove all the rows and all the columns. You can also hide the extra rows and the extra columns which you have. It's up to you. So now this is done. This is what we wanted to do. Now the next thing which we need is the spin button over here. So I'll go to the developer tab. If you do not have the developer tab, you can just simply right click on the ribbon, customize the ribbon, and over here you will have a developer tab. You can just tick on that and click on the OK. I've already inserted it, so my developer tab has already been ticked. Okay, so that's how you get the developer tab. Insert, and then you insert the spin button over here which you see. So let me just insert the spin button very easily. This is how I've inserted the spin button. The moment you insert the spin button, you will see that the design mode is on. What you now need to do is just simply right click on this and click on the format control, or you can just click on the properties. Let me do properties. Why? Because most of us may not be using this version of Excel, so may not have those properties. So we'll just simply right click and go to the properties over here. In this, I just need to make 3 to 4 changes. The very first is that set the minimum to 300, set the minimum to 0 and the maximum to 100. So I'm setting minimum value to 0. This means that this spin button can take the value from 0 to 100. Okay, so this is the maximum. You can increase the size if you want. If you have a bigger picture, then you can make the maximum to maybe 200 or 300. It's up to you. The next thing which I want to change is the linked cell over here which you see. I want to keep the linked cell as H3. So I will just type in H3 over here. So these are the three small changes which I have made. The next change will be the small change which you see. The small change which you see over here, what is this small change basically? The small change is nothing but when you click on this up arrow, the value from 0 will increment by 5 if I type 5 over here. If you type 4, it will increment by 4. If you type 1, it will increment by 1. Okay, I'll just show you all this in a moment. Suppose in H3, this was the linked cell which I had written over here, H3. So in my H3, let me just type in 0. The moment I type in 0, and let me exit the design mode and click on the up arrow, you see the increment is going up by 5 each time. It's going 25, 30, 35, and the moment you click on the down arrow, similar thing happens, it decreases by 5. So it's up to you what increment you want to set. Let me keep it as 5 itself, and I'll just click on the cross button over here. This we are halfway through almost, and now the next thing which we need to do is to get the numbers over here so that we can link these numbers which we have to this cell, and then we can do the conditional formatting. So I will select all these cells which you see. So let me again just adjust the size a bit. Yeah, so I will select all the cells over here and then just simply randomly get the numbers using the rand between function. The numbers which I took was 0 to 100. So let me just keep it as 0 to 100. Instead of clicking on enter, click on control enter. So all the values are populated over here. Now these values are a function. So I need a hard coded value. So I'll just click on control C, copy, control V. The moment you control V, do control V, basically I need to paste it as values. So I will just simply paste it as values, or you can do the paste special from your home tab and just simply paste it as values. What happens is that you get hard coded numbers over here instead of the function. Now there may be certain critical regions of your image and you want to set those critical regions a higher number. You want to give those a higher number, so that can be done. I can just simply change the critical area of my picture to higher numbers, maybe just 80 and so 90. This can be just to get that suspense, feeling of suspense, so that when you are clicking on the spin button, you have the suspense that as to what kind of a picture is going to unfold, right? So this is it, almost done. The next step is we need to custom conditional format this entire region so that if this number over here which you see, which is zero, and the numbers over here, basically if I say that over here we only unfold those cells whose number is less than equal to this number over here. So when I click on the up button, all that particular cell picture will unfold and the rest will remain blank. How can we do this? We'll just simply go. Now the very first step will be to hide the picture, right? So how can we hide the picture? Exactly in the same way as we hid these pictures over here. Just go to the home tab and set the region to white. So picture is hidden. Now just simply go to the conditional formatting. We can create a new rule over here, new rule, and in this we'll click on the format only cells that contain. I will take less than equal to values and I will set this to this particular cell. The format which I want to keep over here is no color, so make sure you have this as, you have set this as a no color, because then what will happen, the white color will go and you'll get at the end a no color over here. And I'll just click on the OK. So you have the no color, OK and OK. So this is how we do this. Now let me just simply click on this and we see we are slowly getting the pictures in that cell whose number is less than the cell H3, the value in H3. So this is how we have successfully able to create picture scramble. But now we need to hide these numbers. So how to hide these numbers? It's very simple. You just need to select the entire range, right click, format cells, and over here go to the custom. In custom, instead of general, I'll just type this as a simple. So here we only have a positive number, we do not have any negative number, so we can just do with one semicolon. If you also want to put negative numbers, then you give two semicolons, one for the positive and one for the negative. Basically giving semicolons means that you do not want anything to appear. It's like You generally give 0, 0.00 and then you give a semicolon. Semicolon represents positive, negative number. This represents positive, this represents negative. So we're not going into details of this. I'll just give one semicolon. You can give two semicolons if you're choosing to go for minimum value as a negative number. So okay, and the numbers are hidden. And we'll just simply click on these and we have our picture scramble ready. So it's very simple. Just maybe 5 to 7 minutes and you have a very interesting picture scramble ready for yourselves. Thank you.